Welcome back to Assassin's Creed Odyssey, guys. This week there's a really awesome item here at the Oiko store from Zargon. It's not a really good item in terms of stats, but it is one of the best looking items in the game. It's the Celestial Torso. And with the Celestial Torso you can make one of the best and most fantastic looking transmog in the entire game. Normally you have to pay for this item for the Celestial set and get the whole set just to get that Torso item here as a transmog, but this week from October 6th to October 13th, 2020, the Celestial Torso is available at Zargon's shop, so this is your once in a lifetime chance to get this item without having to spend money on it. The Celestial Torso is a base item to give you the white skin here where you can apply all your other items on it. And you can also get a really awesome assassin look when you combine the grey Izu Commander's belt together with the shroud. But the real killer look is actually unlocked when you wear this set overnight. The Celestial Torso not only has glowing lines all over it, but it also gives you the glowing eyes, which are extremely cool when you wear the shroud. However, if you own the whole Celestial set, then you can also make the Grey Civilization set together with the Celestial Crown, or if you own the Helmet of the Underworld, you can also combine that with the Red Civilization set, even though the colors are a bit different, but that is also a very incredible look. So in order to make all these looks, I will show you all the items here, including all the other parts. First of all, you have to unlock the Shroud. That is a normal item you can unlock just by playing the main game. Then you have to go for the Athenian Bracers and select the color Decorated Bronze for it. That way they will look much better than the original version. Here for the belt, I picked the Izu Commander's waistband in grey, but you can of course also use the red or the blue variants. These are from the Atlantis DLC. Then of course we have the Celestial Torso, and then for the legs I picked the heavy Athenian greaves, also with the same decorated bronze, so that gives you the same kind of decent color than on your bracers. Of course you can also apply more shiny variants on your bracers and on your boots, but I wanted to pick some decent kind of color here, which fits better together with the Izu style. Of course, you can also combine it with different head colors here, with the Izu Commander's helmet in red or in blue or in green. When you pick both of the Izu items here on the head and on your belt, you can basically indicate that it's a fire build or a poison build when you use the red or the green icons here. Or you just go for the Assassin Shroud here, which is also one of my favorites, probably one of the coolest looking headgears here together with the Celestial skin. Similar to the Izu headgear and Izu belt, the Grey Civilization set and the Black Civilization set can be found from random loot or blacksmith when you play the third episode of the Atlantis DLC. They are not part of a particular set, so you have to rely on your luck so that you find all the missing pieces for it. The Grey First Civilization set has a really cool looking headgear, which is only fully visible when you also wear the torso of this set. Then of course you have to equip all the other pieces, here the First Civilization bracers, the First Civilization belt. All of these items are having the grey look here, especially the torso with the cool green circle, which is really awesome overnight, and the boots here also with some green lights attached. But even better than the original headgear, in my opinion, is the Celestial Crown. It makes this set look so much cooler compared to the original headgear, and it also has a really grayish cool look and some glowing lines on top of it. If you take a look at this set overnight, it's a real killer look. It's almost as good, if not even better, than the Celestial Torso combined with the Izu Commander's helmet and waistband. Just look how beautiful Cassandra is dressed here, absolutely fantastic. It's a real perfect Cassandra Izu warrior look if you ask me, it should be a set in the game. The red First Civilization variant is also an awesome look, especially if you combine it with the Helm of the Underworld. No matter if the colors are a little bit different, but this makes you look almost like a very cool Jedi warrior. You can also find the red versions here of the First Civilization set with the black skin and the red applications in the third episode of the Atlantis DLC. So if this video is all about transmogs, I will also show you my favorite sword transmogs. Most of the time I will use the Chrysaor transmog, which is from a Helix store item. It has a really cool silver sword look with some gold decorations on it. And if I don't use the Chrysaor, then I use the Harp of Perseus, which has a very unique effect, which I will also show you. It really looks fantastic here on the belt. It really feels like a very solid sword that could deal massive damage here. It's not too small, it's not too big, it's not too wide, it just fits perfectly. But when we use the Harp of Perseus, the sword will have a real cool, unique glowing effect. And it is the only sword in the game that really does it. And you can only see it when you use it overnight. I've just paused the game and I will zoom in. You see that the sword is glowing and there are even some particles flying off it. I believe this was meant to be a permanent fire sword with a fire damage engraving instead of being just a normal sword. And it is still glowing, but it has no fire on it. That's actually the only explanation I have for that glowing effect, because no other sword has this effect. And that's why I also like to use it, these glowing particles flying off when you hit your enemies. So I hope you don't mind the shorter video today. Get the Celestial Torso if you can, it's only available this week at Zargon, next week you can only get it from the Helix store again. I've attached some gameplay here for you where you can see the transmog in action. Please don't forget to subscribe, leave me a like, and see you next time.